welcome back to this section of videos on accounting and the time value of money. So the previous video, we talked about future value of lump sums. And in this video, we're going to focus on the present value of lump sums. So let's just jump right into more examples. So here we have a question that says, what is the present value of $84,253 to be received or paid in 5 years, discounted at 11% compounded annually? So just like we did with future value questions, we have to ask ourselves, well, is this a present value or future value question? And is it a lump sum or an annuity question? Well, if we look at this question, it is saying, if we want to have $84,253 in the future, what do we need to invest today to be able to have that much money in the future? At 11% over 5 years, interest compounded annually. So this is obviously a present value question. We want to know, what do we need to invest today? So if you look at the timeline, you can see the question mark is on the present value spot. So now that we've got our interest rate and our periods, we know it's a present value question. We have to determine, is it a lump sum or an annuity question? So the question states that how much would we have to invest today, one-time payment, not multiple every year payments or every period payments, which would be an annuity. So this is obviously a lump sum question. So we're going to go to our present value of a lump sum tables. And this is a little snippet from the table. And we're going to look for 11% column and the 5-period row. And if you look for that factor, you find the factor to be 0.59345. Now remember, this factor incorporates the percentage, the periods, and the compounding. So all that's in there together. And when you multiply that factor times what you hope to have in the future, you find that you would have to invest $50,000 today at 11% to be able to have $84,253 in 5 years. So now you try one. Here we have Caroline and Clifford. They need to have $25,000 in 4 years. So the question is, how much do they need to invest today at 12% compounded annually to be able to have that $25,000 in 4 years? So pause your player. Give this one a shot. Again, remember your questions. Is it a present value? Is it a future value? Is it a lump sum or is it an annuity? That's going to help you locate which table you need to use in this decision process. So push pause on your player and give this one a shot. Okay, so what you should have found is that this is a present value question and it's a lump sum question because we have a one-time payment of $25,000. So if you look at your present value of a lump sum table and you find the 12% column and you go down to row four, where 4 periods are, you find your factor to be 0.63552. You multiply that times the future value amount that you hope to have, and you find that you need to invest $15,888 today to have that $25,000 in 4 years. Now, just as with future value questions, interest is not always compounded annually. It may be compounded monthly, it may be compounded semi-annually, it may be compounded quarterly. So you have to be paying attention to that because that's very, very important when we're using our tables. So let's look at an example of compounding quarterly. Caroline and Clifford need $25,000, so same problem as before, in 4 years. What amount must they invest today if their investment earns 12% compounded quarterly? So again, this is the same scenario. We have a present value question, and it is a lump sum, a one-time payment. But what is our periods and what's our interest rate? Well, when it was compounded annually, it's compounded one time per year, so that would be 4 periods. But now it's compounded quarterly, so now it's compounded 4 times per year. So 4 times per year, and we have 4 years, that gives us 16 periods. And at 12%, remember, interest rates are given on an annual basis, so this is 12% per year. And since it's compounded quarterly, I need an interest rate per period. So if you take the 4 periods or 4 years, and we had 4 quarters per year, so we have 16 periods. We need to get that interest rate per period as well. So what's my interest rate per quarter is basically what I'm looking at here. So 12% divided by 4 quarters per period gives me 3% as my interest rate in this problem here. So we're going to go to our table and look for the 3% column, and we're going to scroll all the way down to 16 periods this time and find the factor to be 0.62317. You multiply that times the amount you want to have in the future, which was $25,000, and you find that you would need to invest $15,579 today to have $25,000 4 years from now, compounded quarterly.